In this clip, I want to introduce label transition systems to model behavior. So I first need to ask the question, what is behavior? And I want to do this with a simple example, a lamp. So what is the behavior of a lamp? For this, we need to ask the question, what can a lamp do? So a lamp can switch on, it can switch off, and as this is a normal lamp, it can also break. So if a lamp switches on, the lamp is on. If we switch it off, the lamp is off. And if the lamp breaks, it is broken. So to the former is what we refer to as actions, to the latter as states. And now we can define behavior as a set of all allowed sequences of actions. Notice that I say allowed actions, because if we have a lamp that switches on, we can't switch it on again. So what is allowed behavior for the lamp? Well, we can switch it on, switch it off, and then the lamp breaks. Or we switch it on, we switch it off, we switch it on, we switch it off, and it breaks. Or we switch it on, and it breaks. Or it directly breaks. So there's an infinite set of behavior. And that leaves us to the question, how do we model behavior? So the principal idea is as follows. If you have an action, then it moves the system from one state to another. And we model this as a graph. So states are represented by nodes, and actions by edges. Here we see an example. So we have a state S with an action A moving to state T. So we say that from S we can move to T via action A. So suppose we have another action from S, say B, and that moves us to U. In that case, we can say, well, we can move from S either with A to T or from S using B to U. So in S we have a choice between A and B. This graph is what we refer to as a labeled transition system. States are nodes, actions are edges. So let's move back to our example of the lamp. What can happen with the lamp? So what do I put in this node, in the state? We see that the lamp is on, so we denote in the state that the lamp is on. And this is also the state where we start. So I label that with this arc over here that states this is the initial state. This is where we start. As a next step, the lamp can switch off. So then we are in a state where the lamp is off. And we got there via the action switch off. In off, we can switch on the lamp again. So that means that we move from off with the action switch on to on. So how about the lamp broken? Of course, we can add a state where the lamp is broken. And we can add an edge from on to broken. And we can add an edge from off to broken. But what do we put on the label? Actually, we don't know, because the lamp can break by just falling, or it can break because the electricity did something wrong. We just don't know. This is what we call a silent action, a step without a label. It can just happen, and we can't influence it. Another question that we need to ask ourselves is the following. When are we happy? So what are the final states of this model? First of all, we are happy if the lamp is switched off, because then it doesn't cost money. So that means that we denote the state off as being the final, and we do this with double edge. You see that the state off now has two edges. And similarly, we are also happy, or at least the lamp is happy, if it doesn't work anymore. So there we have, lamp is broken. So this is the final label transition system of a lamp. It has a state on, that is also the initial state. We can switch it off, we can switch it on again, and it can break. And there are two final states, namely broken and off. Now let's move to the mathematical notation of labeled transition systems. A labeled transition system has a set of states. And we call this one Q. It has a set of actions. Call that A. It has a set of transitions. We denote this with an arrow, and it goes from a state with some activity or action to some other state. And note, it can be an action or a silent step, and the silent step is what we denote with the tau. So it goes from a state with some action or the silent step to some other state. And as we don't want to have all of the arcs, we only have a subset. Then we have an initial state. And we call this one SI, and it is an element of Q. And then we have a set of final states. A set of final states. We call this one omega, and that is a subset of Q. So a label transition system, we give it typically a name, say L. It consists of a Q, a set of states, a set of actions, a set of transitions, an initial state, and a set of final states. So to go back to our lamp, what we see is that we have a set of states Q, and that consists of on, off, and broken. The set of actions is switch off and switch on. I will abbreviate switch off to A and switch on to B. Now, the transitions are as follows. It's a set, so we open the brackets. If we are in on, we can take switch off, which is A, to off. Or we can take an on, the silent step, tau, to broken. If we are in off, we can do an on, which I labeled B, and then it goes to on. Or if we are in off, we can do a silent step to broken. So the initial state, SI, is in our case on. And the set of final states, omega, is in our case off and broken. So the lamp consists of this state Q, this set of actions, this arrow, the initial state, and the set of final states. And we call this one lamp. Now that we've seen the mathematical notation of label transition systems, let's move back to behavior, sequences of allowed actions. So consider transition system L, which has a set of states Q, a set of actions A, a set of transitions, an initial state, and a set of final states. First, we are going to look into single steps. So for example, in our lamp, if we move from on with action A to off, how do we denote this in general? So suppose I have my transition system L, and I'm in some state S, then I want to take action A to some other state S prime. So when is this allowed? This is allowed, we define this as the triple S A S prime should be element of the transitions. So to give an example in our notation, if we're in lamp and we're in state on, we can take action A to off. Or, if we are in lamp and we're in state off, we can take the silent step to broken. Although the last step is correct, I don't really like it, because the silent step is now explicit. And a silent step signifies that the system does it, so I can't control it. So, if we have a system, and it makes a silent step. So suppose I'm in some state S and the system moves to some S prime. I can't influence it. That's why I denote it with a double arc. So what does this mean? This means that either the system is still in the same state, so S equals S prime, or the system has done some internal silent steps. So that means there is some other intermediate state, S double prime. It is a state. And what happened? Well, what happened was that in L, we moved from S with the silent step to S double prime, and the system moved with silent steps, zero or more, to S prime, from S double prime. So how do we read this? This means that if the system takes a silent step, then either it is the same state, or there is some intermediate state such that the system makes an explicit silent step to S double prime, and the system can take zero or more silent steps to S prime. So this is a recursive definition. To give an example in our lamp, so in our lamp, if I'm in state on, I can perform zero or more silent steps to broken, namely one. Or if I'm in lamp and I'm in on, I can move with zero steps to on. So these are all examples of silent steps. Now the next question is, can I combine these IDs? Because now if I'm in state on and I do an action A to off, the system can internally decide to go to broken. And I need to write this down as two steps at the moment in my notation. So can we combine these IDs? So can we create steps surrounded by silent steps? So what is the ID? The ID is, if I'm in my system and I move from S with some sign or with some action A to S prime, possibly surrounded with silent steps. So what does this mean? We define this. So I want to move with action A, but maybe I need to take some silent steps before. So I might take some silent steps to some state S double prime, and S double prime I take the action A to some other state S triple prime, and in S triple prime I take some silent step to S prime. And this is all in L. So this is the ID. But of course these should exist. So these should exist. So they exist states S double prime and S triple prime, elements of Q, such that I move with a silent step from S to S double prime, action A from S double prime to S triple prime, and again a set of silent steps to S prime. So let's apply this on the lamp. So I take the lamp, I'm in on, and then I can take the silent step A to broken. So this A is now surrounded by tau steps, because as what is this state? This state's on. Goes with a silent step to on. It goes with an A from on to off. And it goes with some silent steps from off to broken. Hence, we go in lamp from on with action A eventually to broken via some silent steps. As a last step, we lift these notations to sequences. So suppose we have a sequence, sequence sigma, which is sequence of actions, and let's say it is of length n. Then we want to perform all these actions. So we want to say, if I'm in L and I move from some state S1 with sigma to some state Sn plus 1. This is what I would like to have. So what does this mean? This means that each action sigma I, so each element within sigma, should be possible with surrounded by some silent steps. So I would like to move from some state Si with action Si to some new state Si plus 1. And I want to do this in L. And of course, I need to do this for all actions. So I need to do this for all 1 smaller than I, smaller than equal than n, such that it can take those steps. And of course, this is only possible if those states exist. So S2 up to Sn should all be states in Q. So let's do an example in our lamp. In our lamp, we have a lamp. We are in state on. And let's suppose you want to move A, B, A, B. This is what we want. And what do we want to get up? We want to get into broken. So is this possible? Well, we can move from on with an A to off. In off, we can move with a B to on. In on, we can move with an A to off. In off, we can move with a B to on. And in on, we can move with a silent step to broken. Hence, this is a firing sequence. What have we seen in this clip? We've seen that behavior can be seen as sequences of allowed behavior, and that we can model this with labeled transition systems. And basically, this is a graph to represent the behavior. And we've also seen the formal notation around it. Coming up next, how do we use this in practice?